Welcome to the making of Thriller. Mark.
Way back.
East Los Angeles. It's mainly a Hispanic neighborhood. A lot of industry in this area where we are now on Union Pacific Avenue. And unfortunately, somebody leaked to the press or the radio stations today broadcast that we're going to be all over Los Angeles, Broadway, in this section of town. That's why you see 300-400 children here. And they've all come out to see Michael Jackson.
I heard on the radio that it was going to be downtown LA. We went all the way over there. They tell us he wasn't going to be there. We drove all the way here. We lied. We got in. I saw him. He's great. He's the best.
He dances he's really great, and we'd go
anywhere to see it. We're ready to go to the really other good places.
He's just down to earth, and that's the way I want him to be, down to earth.
He's great. I'm speechless.
He has talent. He has class. He's my man.
And I think he's the best dancer. He's the sexiest man I've ever met in my whole entire life. I love him.
Okay, turn around. Wave to these people. Just wave.
I like Michael Jackson because he can sing good, he's bad, he knows how to dance.
And I think he's so sexy and so gorgeous. And I don't care where he is, I would have gone all that way to see him anyways.
Because he's exciting!
Because he's cute, he knows how to sing good. And
I like the way he dresses.
I like Michael Jackson because he pops. Pops good.
Here goes Ralph.
Go under.
Hey, what channel?
I was impressed because you were real nice on the phone. I didn't think you would be nice for some reason, really.
I was nice on the phone?
Very nice.
I think it was the connection.
Well, we're trying to bring back the motion picture shorts. And I wanted Thriller and Beat It to be a stimulant for people to make better videos or short films. I saw American Werewolf in London. We really, really liked it because it was a different type of horror movie. It was comedy and horror. That's the way I saw it. I said, who's the director who did it? And he said, John Landis. I said, great, that's who we got to get. So I said, get in touch with him.
Sister Hobbs said there's a disturbance in Piccadilly Circus involving some sort of mad dog.
David!
When I met Michael and I went to his house and we talked, I gradually became aware that he knew me from American Werewolf and knew nothing else.
I haven't seen any. Well, I saw a Kentucky Fried movie.
Saw a Kentucky Fried movie.
Which was funny.
So it was like real awkward. George said, well, Michael, I mean, have you seen Trading Places?
No.
Animal House?
No.
Blues Brothers?
No.
Sort of like real depressing.
Those are your biggest ones.
Real depressing afternoon at Michael Jackson's house.
I was on holiday. And I was with my wife and kid in London, just doing nothing. And my agent called me and said, Michael Jackson called. And I went, little Michael Jackson of the Jackson? I get a phone call from Michael Jackson, who very kindly and graciously figured out that London's 8 hours ahead of L.A., so called me at 2 a.m. But anyway, so, and I said hello, and he said, you know my song Thriller? Yes, of course. Put my hand on the phone.
And I didn't know the song. I knew the album, and I knew Beat It and Billie Jean. Bob Giraldi directed Beat It, and Beat It is genuinely good. But the idea of making short little songs doesn't interest me at all. So I said to Michael, listen, Michael, I'd love to make something more elaborate, which Michael picked up on because that's what he wanted to do. His whole thing was, we got to be good, it's got to be great, it's got to be big.
The best.
The best.
So when we stick him for the live cast, we won't actually have to put him in, but when we put him in, we'll put him in like polygraph and stuff so they stay. You know?
When I first walked in Rick's studio, it was like a museum of horror. I mean, all these faces, and I was so amazed by it. There's one man, it's just his head, and it's split open, and all these organs are gushing out in his brains. It's disgusting, but it's brilliant. I think he's an incredible artist.
The very first makeups I ever did were just grease paint makeups, where you just take your standard grease paint material and use it as an artist paints a picture with highlights and shadows, light colors and dark shadows to create and contour the shape. And my father, who's a fine artist, actually taught me how to use that. The principles are the same. Ooh. Then I just did a lot of research, went to libraries and found books on makeup and tried to find ones that got into this kind of work.
What were you like when you were 10 years old?
Pretty strange. I actually started makeup when I was 10. So I made up all the friends in the neighborhood, and usually they were pretty ghastly makeups, third-degree burns and gashes and wounds, and I wasn't allowed in a lot of houses when I was a kid, you know, in the neighborhood.
I don't get tired of doing the same song over and over.
Don't you? Really? Well, the biggest challenge with this film was to be able to get the amount of work that we had to get done in the time that we had. And at one point there's, I think, about 30 different zombies that we created. So we had 20 makeup artists all working, putting appliances on zombies and painting them all up. It's the largest makeup crew I've ever had.
Is it lovely?
Wait till my teeth are in.
Like a lot of dead people. So what we did is that we went down to the Salvation Army and bought a lot of old suits and things, sort of as is. They had holes in them and things, and we took them home and wrecked them. We dunked them in water and we rubbed them on the ground and we slashed them up with razor blades. And we laid them out to dry and stuff. Bugs crawled in them, and I don't know, maybe some bugs are still in them.
Now, zombie.
Much better. Now tell him to come on out.
Come on out, Tony.
Come on. Excellent. Head up, Tony. Head up towards me.
Let's see you. Come on up.
Cut. Very good.
Good.
Where is he? Come here.
Okay. Tony, get down a little.
Yeah. Now look at him. Yeah. There's a picture.
Yeah. Turn it on one more. Right? Yeah, right away. Stand by and go again.
Reach out at his camera. Reach out at his camera.
There you go.
Reach out. That's good. All right, get in the hole.
That looked great, didn't
it?
What?
I said, did it really? Ouch! Gonna put me down, please.
I'll put you down. Let me know when you need Jackson again.
You punk.
Yeah, you have to remember that this is heavy. So as soon as you get it over a little bit, stick your hand in to push it that way. Because
right,
otherwise it looks silly. It just slides over.
Also, I put this hand like that.
That's fine.
Yes, please.
Smoke it up, please. Here's Charles Hughes. Here's Rick Baker. There's people down there. We're going to do it perfect now, aren't we? Okay, let's go.
Okay, you're
right. Okay, we're rolling.
Yes.
Now? Drive speed on both
yes.
cameras?
Speed.
Hold still. Okay, Tom. Get up. Scott. How is that? Yes, all right, print those. Action, Mike. That was great. I'll never get that again. So we'll just drop back to Ola's point of view. Michael, not yet. When I say action, open your eyes wide and come forward. Ready, Cynthia? Everybody? Action.
Four.
What happened? He got pushed away.
Is
that good for you?
How's
that for you?
Let's do it again. John?
What?
78.
Michael's hand's
supposed to go.
After
the interview, I don't know if I'm
seeing
the wrong thing.
No, it's fine. You're seeing it, yeah. It's fine. Like that. And then, if you need more, keep punching away. Yeah. But it'd be great if at that time you could start to try to
please the help. There's a big X here. Make your first punch on that board.
Oh, all right, Ken.
As soon as you get him done.
Okay. Let's go, please.
Quiet. Close the big door.
Put Kevin in. You ready, Kevin? Action. End slate. Excellent. End slate.
Okay, we're going to do this metamorphosis on Michael Jackson. So first I started with his color Xerox of Michael from Rolling Stone. And did these overlays on acetate. First we had to paint out the Rolling Stone and all that. This is just him with corneal contact lenses. We go to scleral contacts, full eye contacts that look like cats. And he's got now a first set of teeth. The next time we see him, he's now got a wig on, a full face foam rubber appliance. We're going to have bladders and little mechanisms in here to start stretching it out and changing it. Which is now a new set of appliances, which is the second life mask that we took, with the teeth in, the contact lenses, new wigs, ears. Another mask. Now it's much more hair, different color. This is what the mask would look like with his mouth open, showing his teeth.
4 minutes.
Well, I think the one thing that Michael really wanted the most in this thriller is to do the transformation. He wanted to change into a monster. I actually was trying to talk him out of it. And he just wants to go through that. I don't know why. You know, I told him how horrible an experience it's going to be and how he gets to do this every day. But he likes the makeup. He likes makeup a lot and has a lot of fun with it. He's a real good person to work with. Okay, Michael, you want to put your hands up to your face? Lean forward real far from the waist, I think. That's good. Yeah. Now start scooting your face all around inside. Just sucking in your cheeks and everything. Don't pull. Okay, it's probably... Okay, it came out beautifully. Okay, let me get some towel.
I got some towel.
Here.
Over to Sean.
Yes. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have your teeth. Here. I wouldn't get a big shot.
Huh? You all right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, now that you're out of there, Michael. We got the first one out. It looks kind of silly because you got those teeth in, but that's it.
That's wonderful.
That's you with the teeth in.
That's great. Hi, Mike. That's amazing.
So that's that. To do the metamorphosis makeup on Michael, the first thing we did was start by gluing latex bladders to his face.
Mm-hmm. And it blows up on the side here, good. Great.
Now, these are basically little custom-made balloons to inflate the foam rubber appliance to a specific shape. These are glued onto his face, and then on top of that, we then glue a foam latex appliance.
The hairpiece comes up pretty far. This is kind of scary here. Can you do that left, right brow? Blow it up. Yeah. That's the end of that piece. See a little edge lifted up here to get outside corner of the eye.
In this case, it's the stage 3. Makeup, which is just about to the final cat monster. After the foam latex appliance is glued on top of the bladders, then the hair pieces go on, and we paint it with a special makeup. It's called rubber mask grease paint.
Rick, I'm real pleased with this. He looks wonderful.
So should we put his eyes in?
Yeah, please.
Aren't those hands great?
I'll be across the room. I can't stand it. Do you want him to sit? Do you want him to sit down?
Uh-huh. I want you to look up for me for a minute.
Sting time.
Well, this won't sting, I don't think. Okay, Michael, you are going to look up, okay? Okay, there you go. Now we got a center of the eye, hopefully. Okay, can you, are you pretty comfortable?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Michael, let's just look up. There we go. Okay.
They're fine until, like, if you go over 15 minutes, they start aching and paining. But when you begin to get physically tired and your eyes get tired, you put these drops in there, it burns like putting Tabasco hot sauce in your eyes. You go, oh, and you're crying and your eyes are red. But up to there is fine.
He's in limbo, and he's dancing. It's all about the dance and Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is still Michael Jackson as a zombie. Michael Jackson isn't Michael Jackson as a werewolf. Michael Jackson is another person totally with the mask.
You put this thing on, and you slowly metamorphosize it into this whole other person. And when you look at yourself in the mirror, you can't help but let the whole mood and the character of it come to life. You can see the way it should walk, the way it should react, the way it should move.
Can you see it now?
That is fantastic. To inflate the bladders, we just use squeeze balms and just use hand pressure to actually squeeze the air into the bladder. We had six bladders on his face today, so we had three operators, each one with two squeeze balms.
All right, you ready? Let's roll it, please.
Roll, please.
Okay. All right, now, Michael, what I want you to do when I tell you to do is open your eyes, start shivering, and make noises.
Why don't you stand up and get over here, if you...
All right? Noises like it hurts. You ready? Action. Now raise the hand a little bit more. Turn it around. Bring it down again. We'll do it again. We're still rolling.
You need more spritz.
Okay.
Whoa, what was that?
That was
top. All right, cut.
Which one was it?
Over here.
I did Beat It with Michael Peters, which I choreographed portions of that as well. And as I told John Landis, I want Michael Peters to work on this thing. And so we got together and we did certain steps and he did certain things. I said, no, I don't like that. And he said, yeah, I like this, or I don't like that, what I did. And we just finally ended up agreeing on, you know, the piece.
Okay, here we go.
Bang, 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 shoulder, shoulder, and bop, and hit, and bop, and a, bada, chin, bada, 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 whack, early picture, bang, or lean,
We have 18 professional dancers. We have four pop lock dancers. I was looking for people that would really get off on what we were doing. And when they walked into the studio the first day, I said, look, this is not a glamour gig, you know? I mean, it's gonna be uncomfortable makeup and dentures in your mouth and, you know, 12 hours of being really weird looking. I said, we love it.
Okay. People, also the only other thing, you'll be helped by the teeth in your mouth, but I watched during the day this time, be aware of your face. I mean, because you're gonna, you know, we'll see it, make faces and stuff.
Okay, now we are now at that point of the day where we throw away all the technical rehearsal, all the cleanup. Now we're gonna work on character, right? Because what I see now is, you know, everybody thinking, okay? Just put it in the computer, let it rest. Let's see a little performance. Quite amazing to me because he's working with these people that have made a living at this. I mean, have studied this for a greater portion of their lives. And he'll walk into a studio and purely on rhythm. I mean, I purely give him a rhythm of a step. And he does it, you know, and it really just, it's fascinating because here are these people, you know, who spent X amount of thousands of dollars training, studying to be dancers for all their lives. And this kid walks into a room and you say, this is the beat, ba, da, 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 and he does it. And it's really wonderful to watch because it's an innate gift that he has. He's a dancer in his soul. Thank you.
just something that you're born with and you can do, and you just continue doing it and you get better and better. After my Motown performance, where I performed Billie Jean, I was nominated for an Emmy, in which I lost. But my real award was the next day after the show when Fred Astaire called my house. He said, I saw the show last night, I taped it, I watched it twice this morning. And he said, you were incredible, you're a hell of a mover. And I said, God, thank you. It's so wonderful for you to say that because I think you're the best. John came to the studio with like 30 photographs of different girls.
And I went in and he started telling me about Michael's video and playing Michael's music, and I had this huge grin on my face. You know, I just stared at the John Landis and had this grin on my face like, oh, you gotta give it to me. I would love to do it. And I got lucky.
Further away from her than this.
Okay.
See what's happening? You're getting way out of here.
Okay.
Should always keep, I mean, just keep that circle around her.
Okay.
Okay? So we'll just try it once more.
Easy for you to do.
Very easy. Watch this. Go ahead.
No, I love her.
The scene with Michael and Ola with the long dolly where they go along and sing. We rehearsed that very briefly and very loosely. We did it like four or five times just to establish the beat so that as long as Ola kept the beat, we could always come back to it. And Michael was left pretty much alone. What I wanted to exploit there was the excitement of Michael Jackson. I mean, nobody moves like Michael Jackson. And that energy and excitement of him relating to another person like that. I wanted to get that electricity.
And you close your eyes and hope that this is just imagination.
Professional.
No, it's like all of us, neither.
I'm an amateur.
Both actors and the director didn't bring the script.
Especially the director.
People are supposed to do that for me. Pam, do you have a copy of the script?
Oh, Pam, yeah.
Call the office and have someone bring us one. Actually, you should know all these lines by Wednesday, anyway.
Okay.
I don't want to go through it again until we're there.
Okay.
Because I don't want to stay.
Well, is it, you know, did you like that?
You can always tell when I really don't like something.
Why?
Because you get real mean. No, it's like,
because I'll tell you.
On action, you step to that one.
Oh, okay.
It's your close-up only.
All right.
You step to that one.
But I stop here first. See, that's what I understand. Come on. John.
All ready? All right, Ola, action.
Fail.
Wrong. Michael, look, wrong. You didn't land at all where you were supposed to land.
I know.
All right, not only did you not land where you were supposed to land, but you landed badly. You have to land, look, you have to bend your leg, you have to act. Watch. So when you, Mike, look, you have to jump up and out.
Yeah.
So you can, you're not on camera here, so you can get yourself all ready. You have to jump up and out so that you land to go.
It's Sunday night. It's about 10 after 10. I'm very tired. We've had a very long day.
This is the famous White Sox shot.
What's going on his toe? Not his toes. Whatever.
We're about 80% edited on Michael Jackson's Thriller short. We finished shooting 3 days ago, so I think we're doing awfully well.
There's music on that though, right?
No, I don't think so. There's sound effects and stuff.
So no accompaniment music?
No,
not on this
so.
Part. Not on this part. No, this, but there's lots of sound effects. There's also the sound of the zombies outside.
What about when we close in on her? She's on the couch.
Oh, it's pretty scary stuff. Oh, here, you want to watch this? Here, turn off the light. Here, watch. This is Michael Jackson. This is Michael Jackson's foot. Now, what very few people know, Michael Jackson is extremely ticklish. Okay, watch. Foot, Michael. What? No, watch. Watch.
No, Jeff.
No, Michael, hold still. Watch.
No! You did that yesterday.
That's all.